Ah, yes, another Lord of the Rings miniature video. Do you know what they say?
I found it is the small things that keeps the darkness at bay.
We're being very cliche today, and we're doing a Hobbit hole, the actual one from the movie. This is actually a gift for my dad for Christmas. I just love fantasy films. It would be a dream for me to work in the art department for a fantasy film. Ugh, I would be so happy. We'll see if we ever get there. Here's a sneak peek. Lots of people have done this. I'm doing it too. And I'm using, it's a peanut container. Of course, we're starting off with the base. Took the peanut can and I built cardboard around it. Glue this into here. Put it up a little bit off the ground so it was like on the hill. I also built above it a little bit as well, where the grass grows over the structure. But I'm actually building lights into this project. They're from the dollar store. So,
the batteries are also from the dollar store, so I doubt that they're gonna last very long.
See how these work. Such a beautiful and complex system. These are actually so good. Shadow box light. That was the only other time that I've had lights. When you're working with lights, you have to keep in mind how you're going to wire them in from the beginning.
I want it to come out sort of around here.
This was a really short strand.
Threaded these two up through here. Laced this one back through.
Lighting the inside of the can. Worked one outside to be the lantern that's above the door.
I guess I'll just glue it here and then I'll just figure it out later.
Three on each side where the windows would be to light those up. It's not rocket science, but now I really wanted to integrate the battery pack. You do have to be able to access it to change the batteries. I made a cardboard space for where the battery pack would fit into the miniature. Track out of cardboard, glued a piece of mat board onto the actual battery pack so that it would slide into the track. That also meant the switch was accessible from the side. Started really building up to give some of the forms a little bit better. Cardboard steps to make a hill in the front.
So we'll kind of do it like a tiered cake. So I've rounded everything out.
Oil from various things. Now, just like my snake den, I crumpled up foil to make rock formations on the hill so that I could paper mache over them later. Take the foil, crinkle it up, glue it on. That's it.
Kind of looks like a victory flyer or something. I'm gonna cover over the wires.
This always looks like a trash pile.
Just you wait.
Then we had to paper mache over the entire thing. Paper mache is just one of my favorite cheap mediums. I feel like I could use it for pretty much anything. All you need is flour, water, and some newspaper. And I don't see that many people using paper mache that often. The one tip that I would give for this project, using thin strips around circle areas. If you use too thick strips, it'll just sort of look very blocky. You have to wait basically overnight for it to dry. In the meantime, we're going to gather some materials from the terrain to make some tiny terrain. Collected some dirt that I sifted through a mesh. Very important for this project for all of the foliage and grass and stuff. I basically just pressed weeds. If you really don't have any kind of budget like me, put them in between the pages of a book. Waited for a couple weeks for them to dry out. The face of the architecture, I did want to sand just a little bit. After that, we started our base layer painting. I painted the face of the house, light yellowy orange sort of color. Just painted the rocky terrain part brown.
Once it looks like a low polygon video game, you know that you did it.
For the terrain, I really wanted to build up layers. Looks more realistic that way, I guess. I'm saying this, but this is the first time I've done terrain like this, so take that as you will. But my first layer for all of the terrain was covering it with dirt. I just went in with some glue, brushed it on, and then sprinkled the dirt over it. Basically like how you put glitter on something. The misty mountains cool. Dungeons deep and caverns old. There's one thing I can say about The Hobbit, it's that this scene, it does get me every time. I think maybe The Hobbit was meant to be a musical with just a band of singing dwarves. That could have been a different movie. I wanted to start the architectural pieces on the house. There are thin frames around the two side windows, so I made those out of paperboard. Most of the architectural details I just made out of paperboard and cardboard. Cut out the window frames.
I'm gonna paint this.
After I had made the window frames, I had to attach the plastic for the glass onto that.
Usually I wait until the end
to try and assemble as much as possible. As satisfying as that is in a video, it's not always the most practical for the actual process. Sequence of events won't be as exciting to watch, but the end product is gonna be a lot better. And then it was time to work on the door, the central piece of this project. And before I cut this down, I'm gonna trace a couple. It has a lot more detail than you would think. Cut a little bit smaller than the opening in the peanut can. Need to leave a little bit of room. I'm gonna paper mache over that. Also add paperboard on top. Painted it as well. Put a thin paperboard strip around the edge of the door. Started layering some of the texture in the Los Angeles Theater miniature. I did this with the stage floor. First I cut out the circle. I cut that circle into strips and then glued those strips onto the door. Now this door does also have where nails are. Really tiny dots of hot glue all over the door to make those. Painted the whole thing green. Had to do some weathering in some areas to make it look not brand new. Had to varnish it because it's a little bit glossy. That's really what kind of sells a lot of these wood pieces. Add some of the details. The doorknob with two beads that I had. They were kind of coppery and like the doorknob. I did also add a hinge. I just used a piece of cardstock. Probably not the most durable thing, but honestly, is he gonna store anything in here? Probably not. The back of the door has swirly iron sort of designs. Went in with glue, drew them with the glue, let that dry, and it creates a slightly raised section. I did also go in and score all of the lines, then I painted it all. It was a wood texture for the inside, and the iron pieces were just sort of like a dark gray. There's two trims around the door. There's a small wooden trim and then there's the bricks. The wooden one was pretty easy. Cut out a circular trim from paperboard and then painted it. It's pretty snug so that we don't get a lot of light leaks.
We're just gonna stick it in there like that.
Am I nervous?
As always. Oh, whoops. Ignore that this window popped out.
Then I started making all of the brick trim. I drew out the shape, two of each, one for a base and one for the bricks that would lay on top of it. I just started laying them on to the base layer with the flour and water mixture that I use for paper mache. I would just kind of like to make it as accurate to brick laying as possible, besides the fact that we're using cereal blocks. Paint on some of the paper mache, press the brick into it, painted the bricks.
Before, after.
Same thing for the trim around the door.
There's one bigger brick and then there's four smaller ones in between and then there's another big one.
Oh God. Here to tell you the secret of crafting is this.
I had lots of chances of turning back, only they didn't. They kept going.
Under the windows, slanted brick boxes. Basically just made a box, sort of cut in half diagonally, laid all the bricks on top of that. The centerpiece is one of the longer bricks, so built a smaller box with the overhanging section, painted them, and then of course I went in and weathered them. It's good to make them look not super uniform. The little lantern above the door, it's another of the same bead that I used for the bottom of the door handle. Stuck it to the bottom. Then I put on a really thin strip of diffusion materials. The top trim I made out of paperboard. It's a little bit thicker than the bottom one. Made some really tiny thin little paperboard braces of the lantern.
We're just gonna trim that in order to get this to fit around the door.
The roof comes out from the hillside. Cut a piece of cardboard and curved it into the shape. Covered all the sides with paperboard, of course. Wedged it in there and glued it on there as best as I could. Attached to the roof, there are wooden braces. I sandwiched two pieces of cardboard together, covered all the sides with paperboard like usual, painted that to look like the sort of grayish wood. I also went in and filled in a bunch of the seams and the gaps with the same paper mache liquid below the two middle wooden braces. Upside down traffic cone looking things. So I did make those out of Sculpey. I just held it up next to it and made sure the shape was right. I used a piece of paperboard to flatten some of the edges. I'm not really the best person to give you advice on sculpting. So once I had all of that stuff made, it was time to start attaching all of it. There is a sort of curved wooden trim right where the roof and the house meet. There is this thing on the left side of the door. Might be like the switch to turn the light on. I'm not sure what it's supposed to be, but we made it anyway with Sculpey. I took those pieces, painted them black, used thread to attach them together. Bottom piece is just hanging off the top, like a telephone or something. And you thought we were done with the bricks. Around the bottom of the door on either side, the bricks sort of go up into like a triangle-y shape. I tried to follow the pattern as much as I could. Now, most of this project was focused on the outside. However, since there were small windows and I was going to be lighting the inside, I made a kind of bottom wainscoting out of paperboard. I just cut it and then drew a pattern on it. Decided that I also wanted to make a little shelf on either side. Cut the shelf out of cardboard, covered the sides with paperboard again. Then I wanted to make some little items to put on the shelves.
My tea-dyed paper from my Victorian letters.
Rolled it up
to make some sort of little scrolls.
A little piece of red thread.
Do we think I could make a loop out of this? I am not very confident.
Oh, there is no way.
I'm just gonna put a little dab of glue here. And I'll just make the loops and we'll fake it.
A couple of little books, not really nice ones because you don't even see them that much. Took a piece of square cardboard and just covered it with some construction paper. Went ahead and glued all of those things in.
Kind of like the Hobbit.
Then I wanted to work with the lights, three on each side, bundled them together, and then glued so you wouldn't see them. And after that, I had to close the sides, blend the roof more into the rest of the hillside. I just had to do all the things that I had done previously. And then it was really time for me to start building the terrain a little bit more. People use blocking for grass. I'm basically doing the same thing with dirt. Mixed it in with some green paint called embedding to sort of stipple on some grass over top of the dirt. Like all of the other things with the terrain, we did this in layers. Darker green first, I did a lighter green.
Granted, this is also from somebody who like literally has never done grass in a miniature before. We're just doing it as well as we can with what we have.
So I'm gonna paint the back green. I'm generally just blending everything in from where I paper mache'd the rest of the back and the sides. So there are steps leading up the hill to the door. I didn't want to use actual rocks for this. First of all, because it would have made everything heavier. The way that I had built everything, I had planned to just use paperboard and build it into the hill, essentially. It kind of doesn't really matter what they look like at the beginning because you just want to get the form.
Wow, such masterful work.
There are also stepping stones by the door. Cut out different stepping stone pieces. They sort of just fit together like a puzzle, so those are pretty easy. Fill in all the gaps with the paper mache material that I'm using for just absolutely everything.
I know that this is gonna look like just a big mess. It will all make sense later.
I hope at least. I sort of use this in the same way that I've seen people use modeling paste. It's just a lot cheaper.
You can also create that rock texture, carved cracks in a couple of them.
Continue that down.
Paint it with some rocky colors, I guess. Dry brush some of like the texture on and stuff. Some cracks. The windows have a really cool pane pattern. Drew those on first with glue to give it a little bit of a raised effect.
It's gonna dry and then it'll look like it did nothing. Looking forward to that.
I went in first with white to give some of the fogginess. Then I went over top and painted it. Then I went ahead and weathered the facade of the house, just adding some variation in colors, some age, and things like that. There are some little flowers just on the side of the door and in the landscape. Made some small white ones. I take tissue paper, fully saturated in water. If you're making it a color, you should dye the water with some watercolor or something. Tear little pieces of it and form them into tiny flower shapes. I actually used a bunch of the ones that I had left from my Spirited Away miniature to blend all the rocks and things, especially the ones near the door that were stepping stones in with the rest of the terrain. Used that embedding technique. Essentially, it just clumps up. Go in with a brush and put it into areas, and it looks kind of like moss. And then I went in with the moss that I usually use for my projects, which I think is called reindeer moss. It's from the dollar store. It's in between the stones as well. Then we went in with the main part of the landscape, which were all my dried plants. They just glued those on, trying to mimic the landscape as best as I could. If you happen to have static grass, which I do not, that would be a great option for this. And so then it was really just the final assembly.
At last comes the end of our fellowship. My work is now finished.
So here is my tiny piece of the Shire. Portable, carryable, take it anywhere. So there it was. I tried to get this video out by Christmas, but
A wizard is never late, nor is he early. He arrives precisely when he means to.
It was really fun. Definitely really different. I haven't done as much natural terrain sort of projects. I'd try to be relatively screen accurate. I think I got pretty close, except for maybe the foliage. We had a good holiday season. As always, if anyone makes this or something similar, or maybe you have in the past, please send it to me. I would love to see it. I don't know, tell me your favorite Lord of the Rings character and why it's Gandalf.